Welcome to Unacademy, the largest online e-learning platform, and welcome to Unacademy semester exams. The course that we were discussing was Network Analysis and Transmission Lines Crash Course, and the topic for today will be Transmission Lines 1 and Types and Parameters of Transmission Lines. Good evening, Soumya. Good evening, Yashwani Priya. Good evening, Srinivas. Welcome to Unacademy. So before that, let me tell you about myself. I am Vice Shravan Kumar, having 7 plus years of teaching experience and mentored more than 5K students for GATE and engineering services and also cracked GATE. Let me also explain you about Unacademy Learning App installation procedure. Click on Unacademy Learning App and click on this install. Once you do this, you can opt for GATE and engineering services and click on this plus subscription and click on this get subscription. You have two types of subscriptions, plus and iconic subscription. You can get subscription to iconic. You'll get a dedicated mentor for your preparation and he'll help you throughout your preparation. And you can also use my code as YSK10 to get maximum discount. And click on proceed to pay. Once you do that, you have debit card, credit card option, EMI, UPI, wallets, net banking. Using any of these, you can get subscription to Unacademy, the largest online e-learning platform. Now let me tell you about this Evolve for GATE 2022 and Ascend for GATE 2023. There are batches that are being handled by the top educators for aspirants of 2022 and 2023. So let's check that once. So this is Evolve for GATE 2022 and Ascend for GATE 2023. We have the top educators of Unacademy. So hurry up and get subscription to Unacademy, the largest online e-learning platform. So that was about the Evolve and Ascend GATE 2022 and 2023. Let me also tell you about Unacademy Combat. It is India's largest fortnightly competition for GATE and it's on January 12th, 2021, 6 p.m. for three branches, ME, CE and EE. So the challenges and original questions curated by the best Unacademy educators. Questions guaranteed to keep the best engaging, challenging as well as fun. So it's a super fast and fun with All India live board. See how you rank against the others for all over India with a live leaderboard showing real-time ranking after every question. Now take the live to compete with the best. Know where you stand among all the other contestants and identify and improve your weak areas with detailed video solutions by the top educators. Get in-depth video solutions for the questions right after the contest. Now you have the score, leaderboard, rating, awards as well. So compete, crack and conquer Unacademy Combat. It is India's largest fortnightly competition for GATE. Assess your GATE preparation in 65 minutes. Challenging and original GATE questions curated by the best faculty of and best educators of Unacademy. Take the live to compete with the best. Super fast fun with All India live leaderboard. Identify and improve your weak areas through detailed video solutions. Next combat goes live on January 12th, 2020 at 6 p.m. So register for free. So the competition format is something like this. It is 60 minutes, 15 questions, 4 combats, 3 cohorts, and relative scoring is based on the speed and the accuracy of the participant. So enroll now in Unacademy Combat. So to participate in Unacademy Combat, sign in on Unacademy Learning App in Google Play Store. To unlock, use CrackGate or you can use YSK10 to get maximum discount of 10%. And the topic for today is transmission lines, types as well as parameters. So let's see that. So transmission lines. The transmission lines are mean of conveying, they are a mean of conveying information. They are a mean of conveying information or power from one point to other. One point to the other. Right? Hi Koteshwar. Hi Shivakumar. Good evening. Sri Raju. Good evening. Welcome. Srishti Imitation Jewelers. Welcome. Good evening. So it is a mean of conveying information or power from one point to the other point, or that means you can say these transmission lines are used for efficiently transmitting power or information from one point to the other. So this is nothing but a transmission line. Augustus, good evening. Welcome to An Academy, the largest online e-learning platform. So now this transmission line will connect source to load. That means it will connect a source and a load. So anything that is used to connect a source and a load can be named as this, a transmission line. Tej, hello, good evening, welcome. Welcome to An Academy. Now, transmission lines are most commonly used in power systems. For power transmission. And also for power distribution. At low frequencies. The normal frequency is 50 Hz. What is the source in that case? The source may be an electrical generator, a transmitter, or an oscillator. So you can call it as a transmitter. So, and the load may be furnace or an antenna or an oscilloscope or any home appliances. So this is, it's a mean of conveying information or power from one point to the other and used for the efficiently transmitting power or information from one point to the other point. And the transmission line connects source and load. And transmission lines are most commonly used in power systems for power transmission and also for power distribution at low frequencies. At low frequencies. The source may be an electrical generator or a transmitter, and the load may be a furnace, antenna, or an oscilloscope. So, now what are the types of transmission lines? The types of transmission lines are open wire transmission line, cables, or underground cables, you can say them, underground cables, coaxial cables, or coaxial transmission lines, that is open wire transmission line, cables or coaxial transmission lines, we can say. You can also say optical fibers and wave guides, also microstrip lines. So these are the different types of transmission lines. So you have an open wire system, a two wire system or a four wire system, and you have an underground cable, and you also have coaxial cables. Underground cables and coaxial cables. Coaxial cable, you have an inner and outer conductors, and for optical fibers you have dielectric core and cladding as well, and waveguides, you have circular waveguide, rectangular waveguides, this will be something like this, and microstrip, it has metal strip with some dielectric . So these are the different types of transmission lines. We'll see some of the advantages and disadvantages of this. First, we'll see what are the certain disadvantages of open wire line. They require telephone post or towers, hence initial cost is very high. So initial cost is high. And also, first one is cost very high. Second, it is affected by atmospheric conditions like wind, air. These are certain disadvantages of open wire system. And maintenance is difficult. If you can see, the maintenance of this open wire system is, third one will be maintenance. So maintenance is difficult. And possibility of shorting due to flying objects and birds. This is one of other disadvantage, shorting. Right, and but the less capacitance compared to the underground cables is advantageous open wire line. So the only advantage we can see is less capacitance effect. So this is about open wire. Now let us see cables. Cables are, these are actually underground cables, and telephone cables consist of hundreds of conductors which are individually insulated with paper, and these are twisted in pairs and combined together and placed inside a protective lead or plastic sheet. While underground electrical transmission line cable consists of two or three large conductors which are insulated with oil impregnated paper and other solid dielectric and placed inside the protective lead sheet. Both these types still considered as parallel conductors separated by a solid dielectrics. So that is, you can see the two types we have discussed here. One is about the telephone cables, other one is underground transmission line cables. Telephone cables has hundreds of conductors, whereas transmission line cables has two or three large conductors. These are also insulated with paper, and they are insulated with oil impregnated paper or solid dielectric, and this is also placed inside a protective lead sheet, and this is also placed inside a protective lead sheet. Both these types are still considered to be parallel conductor type. So let us look at the coaxial cable type. Coaxial cable or coaxial transmission line. As the name suggests, there are two conductors which are coaxially placed. One conductor is hollow and the other is placed coaxially inside the first conductor. This is one conductor and there is another conductor, which this is hollow conductor, and there is another conductor that is placed inside the first conductor. The dielectric may be placed or gaseous. These lines are used for high voltages. These lines are used for high voltages basically. Now, coming to waveguides, these waveguides in this type of transmissions are used to transmit the electrical waves at microwave frequencies, very high frequencies. Constructionally, these are hollow conducting tubes having uniform cross-section area. The energy is transmitted from inner walls of the tube by phenomena of total internal reflection. Here you come see total internal reflection principle. Ramesh Hyderabadi, hello sir. Hello. Yeah, mostly used are open wire. Yes, mostly used are open wires. Yes, in most of the cases, most of the applications you come across this open wire systems, open wire lines. In power transmission and distribution, you come across this open wire lines and open wire systems. So let us once look at these different types of transmission lines. Once again, just so let us look at these transmission lines once again. So in open wire transmission lines, you can see they have less capacitance as compared to the underground cables. That is one advantage. And if you see, the disadvantage, it requires towers which has high initial cost and affected by the atmospheric conditions, and maintenance is also difficult. So that is about the open wire system. And coming to cables, these are underground cables, and if you consider telephone cables, there are hundreds of conductors which are twisted in and insulated with paper, and they are twisted in plates and placed in a protective sheath. While underground transmission cables have two or three large conductors which are also insulated with a solid dielectric and placed in a protective sheath. Both these are still considered as parallel conductors separated by solid dielectric. And coming to the coaxial cables, you have two conductors coaxially placed. One conductor is a hollow and the other one is placed inside the first conductors, and there may be a dielectric or gaseous, and these are used for high voltage levels. And coming to waveguides, they are used to transmit electrical waves at microwave frequency. They are constructionally hollow conducting tubes with uniform cross-section area, and energy is transmitted from inner walls by the phenomena of total internal reflection. So we have seen the different types of transmission lines like open wire cables, underground cables, coaxial cables, waveguides. Right, now let us look at the transmission line parameters. Transmission line parameters. Now, in the previous sessions and in the previous chapters, we have discussed that we have inductor, capacitor, resistor, which are connected. They are all lumped parameters. All these elements are just connected in a circuit. Now, coming to the other type of parameters, you also have distributed parameters. Other type of parameters are distributed parameters. Now, when you consider a transmission line, although you do not have physical RLC and G elements, But if you consider a transmission line like this, let us consider a transmission line. And this transmission line, if you see, because this is a wire, a conducting material, it has an internal resistance, and whenever it is carrying some current, a flux is induced in it, so it has some inductance property. And these two wires are having different currents at different potentials, so there exists a capacitance between them. Also, there will be a conductance between these two. So you have resistance property, inductance property, capacitance property, and conductance property, which are uniformly distributed, throughout the length of the conductor. So I have considered just open wire system. If you see any transmission line, it has all this. So these parameters R, L, C, G are called as distributed parameters, which are not physically separable, but their properties will exist in this transmission line. Because every conductor being a practical conductor, every practical conductor has a resistance inside it. And if you see, because it is carrying some conductor, according to Estard's experiments, every current carrying conductor has flux around it. So you have an inductance property, flux, inductance, and two parallel plates. That means two wires separated by some distance will exhibit a capacitance property. And also you have a conductance property existing between them. There will be some sort of conduction between these two. There is a, because of this low dielectric path, if there is a dielectric, air is considered to be a dielectric, because of that dielectric, it will find a conductance property here. So R, L, C, G are the four distributed parameters, and these transmission line parameters actually are classified into two types: primary and secondary. Primary constants or parameters and secondary constant, transmission line parameters or transmission line constants. Now this resistance, inductance, capacitance, and conductance are called as primary constants, and characteristic impedance and propagation constant, Z, is called as the characteristic impedance, which we'll learn in the upcoming classes, and gamma is the propagation constant. So these two are called as the transmission line parameters or primary and secondary constants. Now let us look at the equivalent circuit of this. Equivalent circuit of transmission line. Equivalent circuit of transmission line. So before that, let us look at the basic principle of transmission line. So let us look at this transmission line. You have, let us consider one transmission line. Let's say this is the transmission line which has input and there is a load that is connected here. If we consider this transmission line, there is an input There is a load ZL. So ZL, we call it as load impedance. And this S is called as the spacing between the conductors. And if you consider this as source or input, this is the input, let us call it VS, source or input. And this L is the length of the conductor. L is the length of transmission line. Length of the transmission line. L is the length of the transmission line. Now let us draw the equivalent circuit. Just like so, just like a two-port network, transmission line also has inductance, capacitance, resistance. The only difference is these are uniformly distributed. These are uniformly distributed along the length of the transmission line. The only difference between a two-port network and a transmission line is these are uniformly placed. Now, since, as I told you, the conductor or transmission line, you say transmission line used is not an ideal conductor, so it has some length and diameter. It has some length and diameter, and also there exists a resistance, internal resistance called series resistance, that is R. If you look at the next one, as I told you, since every current carrying conductor has flux or magnetic field around it, the transmission line must process, the transmission line must possess, the transmission line must possess inductance L property with units Henry per meter, and previously the units of resistance here are ohm per meter because these are distributed along the length. So if you just take the next one, since the dielectric between the two transmission lines is not an ideal one, since dielectric between two transmission lines is not ideal one, some current leaks through it from one conductor to the another. That means if there is some leakage, therefore transmission line must possess, therefore transmission line must possess capacitance or conductance. You can say because it is leakage conductance, that is G denoted by, and units are mho per meter. So we have RLC which are uniformly distributed, and the conductor used is not an ideal one, therefore it has, there exists some resistance opposition, that means. And if you observe, since every current carrying conductor has magnetic field around it, the transmission line must possess inductance. Since the dielectric between the two transmission lines is not an ideal one, there will always be a leakage, and that is called as the conductance. Now let us consider both conductors carry current in opposite direction. Both currents carry current in opposite direction and are separated by some distance. Therefore, there exists a capacitance, and they are separated by some dielectric also. Separated by some distance and dielectric. There exists a capacitance phenomena. Therefore, you have capacitance C, which is farad per meter. Now, if you want to represent all these, so these, you can draw this RLCG are known as line parameters and are called, or also called as primary constants of transmission line. So these are transmission line parameters and these are primary constants, and you also have something called secondary constants, which are gamma and z naught. So now just want to denote this with some transmission line. So you can denote it as resistance, inductance, and then in parallel with you have a conductance and capacitance. Similarly, as you move on some distance, you again have a resistance and an inductance, then a resistance and a capacitance. Then if you move on again, you have resistance and an inductance, and so on. Here also, and so on, you have this transmission line. So now you have to represent this. This is R, L, this is L, G, C, G, C, R, L. So what is R? Resistance. So we'll write this in the next slide. R, L, C, G. Now what are these R, L, C, G? R, L, C, and G. R is the resistance per unit length, ohm per meter. Similarly, L, inductance per unit length, Henry per meter. And C, capacitance per unit length, farad per meter. G, conductance per unit length. So it is mho per meter. So these RLCG are also called as primary constants and also called as line parameters. And you also have something called as secondary constants. They are Z naught and gamma. They are Z naught and gamma. And these RLCG will depend on RL, C and G will also depend on the first one. It is type of the conductor used. It also depend on type of conductor that we use and type of dielectric used. Type of dielectric used and physical dimensions of wire and distance. Physical dimensions of wire and distance. And distance, physical dimensions of the wire and distance between them. So these are the parameters on which the RLCG will depend. One is it's a type of the conductor and type of the dielectric used. Physical dimensions of wire and distance between them. So now let us see what are the uses of transmission line. Uses of uses of transmission line. If you consider the first use of this is it is used to connect a transmitting antenna to transmitter. It is used for connecting transmitting antenna to transmitter. Now let us consider the second one. It is also used for connecting receiving antenna to receiver. Third, it can be used as a circuit element like series LC, parallel LC and resonant circuit. Then the last one is it can be used for impedance matching. It can be used for impedance matching. Why do we match impedance? For maximum power. For maximum power transfer from source to load. So let us see these two things once again. So RLCG will depend on the type of the conductor used, type of the dielectric used, physical dimensions of the wire and distance between them. And also if you see the uses of transmission lines are, it is used for connecting transmitting antenna to transmitter and receiving antenna to receiver, and it can be used as a circuit element like series LC, parallel LC and resonant circuit. And it can be used for impedance matching for maximum power transfer from source to load. It can be used for impedance matching for maximum power transfer from source to load. So these are some of the things that we have tried to discuss. So let us see if once again everything. Yeah. So first we have discussed First, a transmission line. First, we have discussed about the transmission line. What was a transmission line? It is a mean of, it is a way of transmitting information or power from one point to the other point. Then I told you about the different types: open wire cables, coaxial cables, and waveguides. And we have discussed about the various advantages of open wire and what are cables and two types of cables: electrical transmission line and telephone cables, underground cables, and also coaxial cables, and which are used for high voltage levels, and waveguides, which work on the principle of total internal reflection. Then we saw what is transmission line parameters. We have RLC element, which are previously we have seen lumped parameters, and now we are looking at the distributed parameters which are present in the transmission lines. So if you look at an open wire transmission line, you can observe these properties of resistor, inductor, capacitor, and conductance existing in the transmission line. So the transmission lines, the transmission line parameters are primary constants RLCG. You also have secondary constants as Z0 and gamma, propagation constant, and characteristic impedance as well. Now we try to draw the equivalent circuit. Before that, we have just looked at the basic transmission line circuit. It has a source and a load, where you have this is the transmission line, which are separated, has some spacing between the conductors, and these are length of the transmission lines. So just like a two port network, transmission line also has RLC elements, but these are uniformly distributed. That's the only difference, and the conductor or the transmission line used is not ideal conductor, so it has some resistance, which is ohm per meter. Then we have, since every current carrying conductor has magnetic field and it around it, the transmission line must possess inductance property, which is Henry per meter. And since the dielectric between the transmission lines is not ideal, some current will leak so through it from one conductor to the other. Therefore, you have some conductance property also existing, which is mho per meter. And both conductors carry current in opposite direction and are separated by some distance and dielectric. Therefore, there exists a capacitance phenomena. So capacitance is farad per meter. So all these RLCG are line parameters and also called as primary constants of the transmission lines. Now we have seen this is the equivalent circuit. Equivalent circuit of transmission lines. You have a resistor and inductor, and resistor and inductor, conductance and capacitance, and conductance as well as capacitance, resistance and inductance in series. These are series. This is a shunt branch, and this is also a series branch, and this is also a series branch, right? Now if you look at these parameters of transmission line, R, L, C and G. R is the resistance per unit length measured in ohm per meter, L is the inductance per unit length measured in Henry per meter, C is the capacitance per unit length measured in farad per meter, and G is the conductance per unit length measured in mho per meter. And all these RLCG elements, RLCG, are called as the primary constants or line parameters, and Z0, gamma are called as secondary constants. Now then we have seen RLCG will depend on, that means on what parameters does these RLCG values depend. That means they depend on the type of the conductor we have seen, And then we have seen they depend on the dielectric used. They also depend on the physical dimensions of the wire and the distance between them. Then we have seen what are the uses of this transmission lines. They are used for connecting transmitting antenna to transmitter, also receiving antenna to the receiver, and this can also be used as circuit elements like series RL, parallel RL, or sorry, series LC, parallel LC, and resonant circuits. And it can also be used as a impedance matching for the maximum power transfer from source to the load. So this is about the transmission lines and transmission line parameters. Transmission line and parameters, transmission line types, transmission line types and transmission line parameters. So we have discussed about these types like open wire cables and coaxial cables and waveguides. And transmission line parameters R, L, C, and G. So this is about the transmission lines and transmission line parameters. So as I always tell you, we have India's number one study channels, Creatrix Gate, Creatrix Anacademy Gate, Anacademy SSCJE, Anacademy Computer Science, Anacademy Gate Telugu, Anacademy Gate CE, Anacademy Gate Questions, Anacademy Computer Science, Anacademy Engineering Foundation, Anacademy Pathshala, Anacademy Electrical Junction, Anacademy Semester Exams. Also, let me tell you about this Ascend and Evolve for GATE 2022 and 2023. So the batch has already started, and there are so many other batches that are coming up with the top educators teaching for you. And hurry up and get subscription to Anacademy, the largest online e-learning platform. Also, let me tell you about this Combat, Anacademy Combat. Anacademy Combat is India's largest fortnightly competition for GATE. It is live. It will be live on January 12, 2021 at 6 p.m. for ME, CE and EE students. And there are challenging questions that are original, that are curated by the best educators, and questions guaranteed to keep the test engaging, challenging, as well as fun. Also, you'll have a super fast and fun with live All India leaderboard. See how you rank against the others with live leaderboard that shows real-time ranking after each and every question. Right? So you can take it live to compete with the best. Know where you stand among all other contestants. Also, you can identify your weak areas and get detailed video solutions of them, and get in-depth video solutions for the questions right after the contest. So compete, crack and conquer. You have score, leaderboard, rating and awards. So it is India's largest fortnightly competition for GATE, and you can assess yourself within 60 minutes, assess your GATE preparation, and you have challenging original GATE questions by the faculty and academic educators for ME, CE and EE eligible branches. So you can take this live and compete with the best, and it is super fast and fun with All India Live Leaderboard. Identify and improve your weak areas by the detailed video solutions. So the next combat goes live on January 12th, 2021 at 6 p.m. So register for free enough. So the competition format will be something like this. It is 60 minutes competition with 15 questions, 4 combats, 3 cohorts, and relative scoring will be based on your speed and accuracy. So enroll now for an academy combat. To participate in an academy combat, sign in on an academy learning app. You unlock it by using Crankgate. You can download this from Google Play Store. So that is all about an academy combat. An academy combat which goes live on January 12th at 6 p.m. So don't forget, participate in this an academy combat. And once again, like this video, share this video, use my code YSK10 to get maximum discount of 10% on your next an academy subscription, and also subscribe to an academy and an academy semester exams, and click on this notification to get click on this bell icon to get more notification of my classes. Once again, thank you all. Thank you for joining me this session on transmission line types and parameters. Thank you.